Yes, beta, we are doing the chapter enemy from another book, Vistas, and one more chapter is left after this. So we'll continue from this. Dr. Sadao, Hoki, and Hana, they saw Tom, an American prisoner, on the seashore, that coastal area. So now the chapter is when they are married. They have already told us how they got married and all. So when they were having good time of life, when they were standing hand in hand at the sea coastal area, then suddenly they saw a black image emerging out of the sea waters. And it, you know, sea waves are quite strong enough to throw even a person. So with the one of the waves, they saw a man was hurled upon, when fenka gaya in that way, on that coastal area. And they thought that one of the, from a distance, it was not visible. So they thought of checking who that man is. And they firstly thought, they had preconceived notion, it can be one of the fishermen, because fishermen, they are very habitual of going into the sea and all, fine, this is their profession. And every now and then it was common sight to find the dead body of a fisherman also. So they thought one of the fishermen is wounded and we should help him. Fine. But when they saw that, they turned that man upside down, they saw the uniform which he was wearing, and that shows that he was an American. His nationality was American. He was wearing a cap and proper uniform. And through that, they got to know, and probably because World War II was going on, how did American person found on the shore of Japan? It means he was an escapist, a prisoner who has run from the prison. And after getting wounded in the war, and he was having a gunshot also on one of the shoulders. So when they found that gunshot, and see the smartness at the back, he was having gunshot. When do a person, when does a person have a gunshot at the back? When he's trying to run, obviously. So this is a common thing. So they perceived, okay, he was having a gunshot at the back, and he is, they just could perceive, okay, he is a prisoner of, American prisoner who has run from during that war. So then dilemma of choosing between duty towards nation versus duty towards profession. Dilemma is state of confusion. So they were in state of dilemma. What should we do now? Firstly, Dr. Sadao thought of, and his wife too, both of them, they thought of throwing the man back into the waters. Because when they found the nationality, they thought if anybody gets to know that they are helping an enemy, that will be a threat to their own life. So who puts one's life in danger? So they decided ki we should throw back him into the water, but no. Dr. Sadao was, you know, inside being a doctor, he was very humane in nature. I'm not using the word human. I'm saying humane, N-E. Fine, humanitarian grounds. Some people are very, you know, harsh. They do not have empathy for others. They do not feel for others. But he was very, you know, having that feeling of empathy, and he would relate, he, as his father has imbibed such values in him, that we should help everyone. So he thought, I should at least give him first aid, and then I should hand him over to the authorities, or let's see what we will do. So Hana and Dr. Sadao took that prisoner into their home, and see the contrast they have mentioned, where they will be keeping this man, in the room of Dr. Sadao's father. His father is no more now, his father is dead. And the room is beautifully decorated with Japanese tradition. And in Japanese tradition, an American prisoner of war is lying on the bed. So this is the contrast. Blood is same in everyone. Body is same. God has made everyone same. The differences are of opinion of people. Differences are created by human beings only. Fine. God has not created any difference. We people have created. So this is the satirical or ironical irony of the situation, you can say, that American prisoner was lying in the room of a typical Japanese man, and he was being treated by Japanese people, those who are enemy, those who are hailing from enemy country actually. So they saved his life after a few days when he was into his consciousness. He was a young boy, a handsome boy from Army of America, and he thought of running, and he thought, why they are helping me? He was having again suspicion over them also. So anyhow, how they get along, if they help them to escape or they kill that boy or they will hand him over to the authorities, that I will not disclose to you. Fine. Then protest of helpers. Humanity wins. Why I have written humanity wins at last? Because they decided to help him. That's why I have written this point. Fine. And protest of helpers. And most of the Japanese people, all the help, house help, gardener was there. And one cook was there, Yumi, because they are having, Yumi is her name. And they are having, you know, younger kids at home, Dr. Sadao and Hana, two kids they have. So for that, they have kept house help. Fine, cook is there, attendant is there, and gardener is there. So they will protest and they will leave the house. And Hana also into the same profession, she has to do all household chores all alone. So whether she'll be frustrated out of it and they will throw this man out, what do they do? Let's continue. I'll be sharing the screen with you all. But is it clear to everyone? The children sitting at home? Fine. Let's continue from next page. We are on page number 26. This is page 26. This is the picture you can see of that black image which came out of the water and was lying on the seashore. Fine, on the page 26 only. Let's continue. Now he felt her. In the first paragraph, they have just told that how he missed the chance. He would have missed the chance of meeting his wife, Hana. But anyhow, this destiny was there and he met Hana. And finally, they got married. And now he felt her hand on his arm and was aware of the pleasure it gave him. And now this is the reality. After getting married, now they are standing at the sea coastal area. Yahan se start ho rahe. Even though they had been married, yes, beta, page 26, second paragraph. 26 page pe aap. This is the page, okay? Where this image is made, okay? Ye wala page hai, second paragraph. Now he felt her hand on his arm and was aware of the pleasure it gave him. Even though they had been married years enough to have the two children, for they had not married heedlessly in America. Heedlessly means thoughtlessly. Without giving a single thought. So they did not get married. Let's okay get married and all in that way. Kiddish way. They had finished their work at school. So this is one viewpoint I always discuss with teenagers. When it comes to choosing the partner in life. You know, people are very hesitant of talking about this topic. This is not the right age. What happens is in teenage, we have attractions only. This is not the true love of life you find and you know, stars start emerging and you start feeling. Because this is the time when you have just attractions. We should talk about this topic. The real thing is you should find a companion for life. Not for a moment or 2 days or 5 days. And to find, you have to find compatibility. When there are various parameters about your professions, your backgrounds, your mental match, emotional well-being of the two people. There are many things one should see. It should not be a hasty decision. Fine, after meeting someone, you fall for a person and okay, let's do it. Let's get married. No, this is not the time. Fine. So they are saying that they did not get married heedlessly. They spent quality time together. Firstly, they decided because this is the time to give this, you know, from 18 to 23 or 24, I guess. This is the time when you should give time to your profession only. When you become something, when both the boys and girls never think that we will, you know, be dependent on a man for after marriage and all. Never. Firstly, be self-dependent. You know, be proficient in your profession and then think about the other purpose of marriage and all. So what they did, they completed their work. They finished their work at school. They come to Japan. And when his father had seen her marriage had been arranged in the old Japanese way, although Sadao and Hana had talked everything over beforehand, they were perfectly happy. She laid her cheek against his arm. So everything was done with the consent of parents. If parents are giving consent, then they decided to get married. It was at this moment that both of them saw something black came out of the mist. So when they were standing together after having two children, and now they are thinking how that happened. And finally, a black image started coming out of the waters. It was a man. He was flung up out of the ocean. Flunge, it seemed, to his feet by a breaker. He staggered a few steps, and it was not that his body hauled out. It was a walking man. He was staggering. Staggering means ladkhada ke chalna. Fine? So you can say unsteady movement. Staggering means unsteady movement. His body outlined against the mist, his arms above his head. Then the curled mist hid him again. Due to the misty weather, sometimes he was visible, sometimes he was not. Who's that? Hannah cried. She dropped Sadhav's arm and they both leaned over the railing of the veranda. Now they saw him again. The man was on his hands and knees crawling. The man fell on the ground and he started crawling like a baby. Then they saw him fall on his face and lie there. And finally he fell on his face and lie unconscious over there. A fisherman, perhaps, Sadhav said, watched from his boat. He ran quickly down the steps behind him. Hannah came, her wide sleeves flying. A mile or two away on either side, there were fishing villages. But here was the only bare and lonely coast, dangerous with rocks. The surf beyond the beach was spiked with rocks. Spiked means beta, sharp protecting points. Spiking is that there were many pointed points over there. Somehow the man had managed to come through them. He must be badly torn. What they are saying, after getting the gunshot, that man fell into the water and there are rocks into the water and many pointed spiky things, and he got hit into it and he was badly injured. It means the vitality of the man. It means that the power and energy was too much because he was young enough to bear it. After gunshot, after getting many pointed objects into his body, after being hit to the rocks, he was still alive. That shows that he was having power. Tough guy he was. And they saw when they came toward him that indeed it was so. The sand on one side of him had already a stain of red soaking through. So red soaking was due to the blood coming out of his body. He's wounded, Sadhav exclaimed. He made haste to the man who lay motionless, his face in the sand, an old cap stuck to his head, soaked with seawater. He was in wet rags of garments. Sadhav stopped Hannah at his side and turned the man's head. They saw the face. A white man, Hannah whispered. Yes. It was a white man, means American man. The wet cap fell away and there was his wet yellow hair, long as though for many weeks it had not been cut. And upon his young and tortured face was a rough yellow beard. He was unconscious and knew nothing that they did for him. So he was unconscious. He was American, having, they have just mentioned the color of the hair, rough yellow. Now Sadhav remembered the wound, and with his expert fingers, he began to search for it. With his fingers, he started exploration of the wound. Blood flowed freshly at his touch. On the right side of his lower back, he saw a gun wound had been reopened. So where the gun wound was there, right side of his back. The flesh was blackened with powder. Sometime not many days ago, the man had been shot and had not been tended. It was bad chance that the rock had struck the wound. So after getting gunshot, he was struck into rocks and he was badly wounded. Oh, how he's bleeding, Hannah whispered again in a solemn voice. The mist screened them now completely. And at this time of the day, no one came by. The fisherman had gone home. Even the chance beachcombers would have considered the day at an end. What do you mean by beachcombers? A person who searches along the shore. Beachcombers are the people who keep on searching for objects round the seashore. It means not a single sign of beachcombers, not a single sign of fishermen. Koi dur dur tak nahi tha. And only this American prisoner was lying there. What shall we do with this man? Sadao muttered. But his trained hands seemed of their own will to be doing what they could do, stanch the fearful bleeding. You know, the people who are very duty bounded, his hands were automatically, you know, trying to help him. Blood is flowing like anything, I should stop it. And haath uske rok rahe hain blood ko, and saath mein wo pooch rahe hain ki, what should I do with this man? Fine, that shows that he has genuine heart. And what he does, he packed the wound with the sea moss. Sea moss is a sea plant. Whatever he was having, he stopped with the plant, with the help of that plant, he stopped the blood flowing out of the wound. That strewed the beach. Strewed means scattered. Strewed, S-T-R-E-W. Strewed means scattered. The man moaned with pain in his stupor. Stupor, beta, dull condition. You can use these words while writing the answers. S-T-U-P-O-R. Stupor means dull condition. But he did not awaken. He was unconscious. The best thing that we could do would be to put him back in the sea, Sadao said, answering himself. So who decided to put him back? Dr. Sadao himself, not Hana. Fine? We are on next page or the same page? Yehi pe abhi. Here, okay? Yes, the kindest, then what he did after saying this. Now that the bleeding was stopped for the moment, he stood up and dusted the sand from his hands. Yes, undoubtedly that would be the best thing, Hana said steadily. So she agreed to what Dr. Sadao said. Dr. Sadao said, let's throw him into the water, and Hana agreed. But she continued to stare down at the motionless man. What does it show? She is also looking motionless man, and he also is trying to stop blood. That shows both husband and wife are good enough. If we shelter a white man in our house, we should be arrested. And if we turn him over as a prisoner, he would certainly die, Sadao said. This is the dilemma, beta. Chhod denge to definitely he will die. And if they will save him, and they will, you know, get arrested by their own army. The kindest thing would be to put him back into the sea, Hana said. But neither of them moved. Bol rahe hain. Their actions and words are not matching here. Because unka dil keh raha hai ki we should help him. But neither of them moved. They were staring with a curious repulsion upon the inert figure. Repulsion means act of denying something. Mana karna kisi cheez ko. So what is he? Hana whispered. There is something about him that looks American, Sadao said. He took up the battered cap. Battered means damaged. So damaged cap he took. Yes. Almost gone was the faint lettering. A sailor, he said, from an American warship. So he's a sailor of American warship. Underline. This is the identity of that term. Name uska abhi nahi pata hai unko. When he will be having consciousness, then he will tell his name. Okay. He spelled it out. Kya likha tha wahan pe? US Navy. The man was a prisoner of war. So they could perceive that he hailed from American Navy. You know about the armies? Fine, jo water army hoti hai, usko hum Navy mein keh dete hain. So US Navy, he was part of that. He has escaped, Hana cried. And that is why he's wounded in the back. They hesitated looking at each other. Then Hana said with resolution, come, are we able to put him back into the sea? If I'm able, are you? Sadao again asked, are you sure? No, Hana said, but if you can do it alone. Sadao hesitated, Kethi, you can do it, I don't want to pick him. Strange thing is that if the man were whole, I could turn him over to the police without difficulty. I care nothing for him. He's my enemy. All Americans are my enemy. And he's only a common fellow. You see how foolish his face is, but since he is wounded, वो यहाँ पे चुप कर जाता है. वो क्या कह रहा है यहाँ पे? Doctor Sadao is saying कि अगर वो complete without any wound I might have found him, I would have handed him over without a single thought, because he is my enemy. But he is wounded. उसकी जो condition है, उसको देखते हुए, I am not, you know, able to hand him over. So as a doctor, he wanted to treat him. You also cannot throw him back to the sea, Hana said. Then there is only one thing to do. You must carry him to the house. But the servants, Sadao inquired, कहता हमारे घर पे तो servants हैं. What do they say? You must simply tell them that we intend to give him to the police. So Hana suggested कि हम उनको बोलेंगे कि हम इसको पुलिस को दे देंगे ठीक करने के बाद. As definitely we will do so. We must think of the children and your position. Then Sadao said, we have children at home. If would endanger all of us if we did not give this man over as a prisoner of war. सबकी life खतरे में है. हमारे बच्चों की servants will go. Think about it. Certainly, Sadao agreed. I would not think of doing anything else. So Sadao is now saying that I cannot think about anything else. So thus agreed together, they thought, they lifted the man. He was very light like a fowl. Fowl is a bird, beta. Itna halka tha, he was not a fat man. Aur kyun wo patla tha? He has not been eating some for a few days. Na to usne kuch khaya tha, wounded tha. पता नहीं कितने दिनों से ही माइट बी हैव इन ऑशियन एंड ऑल. सो हिज आर्म्स हैंगिंग लाइक अ स्केलेटन ओनली. दे कैरिड हिम अप द स्टेप्स इनटू द साइड डोर ऑफ द हाउस. द डोर ओपन इनटू अ पैसेज एंड डाउन द पैसेज दे कैरिड द मैन टुवर्ड्स एन एम्प्टी बेडरूम. इट हैड बीन द बेडरूम ऑफ सदाओस फादर एंड सिंस हिज डेथ इट हैड नॉट बीन यूज्ड. उसके फादर की डेथ के बाद नोबडी हैड यूज्ड दैट सेम रूम. एवरीथिंग हियर हैड बीन जापानीज टू प्लीज द ओल्ड मैन. Who would never in his own home sit on a chair or sleep in a foreign bed. Hana went to the wall cupboards and slid back a door and took out a soft quilt. She hesitated. The quilt was covered with flowered silk and the lining was pure white silk. Obviously, a wounded man hai, khoon nikal raha hai, and she is having beautiful quilt of silk. She was hesitant ki main kya use karun isko pehle to make him, you know, comfortable. He's so dirty, she murmured in distress. Yes, he had better be washed, Sadao agreed. If you will fetch hot water, I will wash him. I cannot bear for you to touch him. How can you touch this dirty man? Itna uska bura halat tha na dekhne wala. We shall have to tell the servants. He's here. I will tell you me now. She can leave the children for a few minutes and she can wash him. So Hana thought, I'll take the help of the servants, but that will not be a good idea. Okay, bell is gone, so we'll continue tomorrow. Everything clear to the children sitting at home? Okay, beta. So we'll continue tomorrow.